10 tips for being productive when you're working at home. Where you be, beep, beep.
Watch the actor.
Woke up at 11 o'clock. I ain't got no job. What the hell should I do today? This feel like some, I don't give a fuck. Oh my god, shut the fuck up. I ain't hearing what you gotta say. I know in my soul, I hate this fucking cold, yeah. That's just how it goes.
My name is Shami, for those of you who do not know me. Today, I wanted to share with you guys 10 tips for being productive when studying or working from home. As someone who is proficient at staying at home, even without the current situation of a pandemic, I got you covered, guys.
Frankie, you got them covered, right?
You guys gonna know all the secrets for being efficient. Tip one, figure out the time where you're most productive. For some people, it's super late at night, and for other people, it is super early in the morning. I am not a morning person, but I am super productive in the morning, so it sucks for me. The best thing about working from home is that you don't have to try and fit into someone else's schedule. You have the power to utilize the time that you work best. You don't have to work 9 to 5. Tip two, everyone says this, but it's true. Get ready, feel presentable, show up for work at home, just as if you were showing up for work when you go into the office or when you go into school. The home is where you do everything. It's where you sleep, where you relax. You really need to create a divide between that and work time and study time when you're at home, when you're working from home. A great way to do that is by getting dressed. There is a couple other ways to do it too. For example, getting a workout in the morning and just like dividing your day so it doesn't just feel like you just got up and you're still kind of asleep. Changing the location from when you hang out and watch Netflix to like where you work also helps, you know? Don't study on your bed. Sleep in your bed. Don't study on the couch. Watch Netflix on your couch. Tip three, create a dedicated workspace. This kind of follows on from tip two. Don't do it on your couch, don't do it on your bed. Find a place that whenever you have to study or work, you go to this one place and it's associated with that one thing. You don't want to stay at home, go to a coffee shop. If you do go to a coffee shop, make sure that there's Wi-Fi, PowerPoint there to plug in your computer if you need it. I usually search up work-friendly cafes online, or you can invest in a co-working space. Most of the time, what's really fun is co-working spaces have like a week trial or a day trial where you work with other people who are also working. So you can see if you really like it and invest in a co-working space. Tip four, make a to-do list. This to-do list that you're going to make is only for the session that you're in. It's not about your laundry. It is not about what dishes you need to wash. It's the tasks that you want to get done in your study or work session only. And you want to prioritize those tasks. So the ones that are the most important go on the top. But I also suggest putting in some like easy, like check my email tasks, or like take off this one easy to do thing so it makes you feel accomplished first. And then get into the hard, gritty to do's. Tip five, create a playlist. Whether it's a study music playlist that are kind of already available online. If you go on YouTube, you can find heaps of classical music, study music playlists that really help you focus and that actually engage with waves in your brain to encourage focusing on one task. What's great about this is that it gives you state dependent cues to your body. So you know when you hear this music, it is time to work, time to be productive, it's time to get shit done. Tip six, blocking your social media. Social media can be a grand distraction. It is always a massive distraction for me. Throw away your phone from where you're working. Don't install any of the social media app or install Chrome extension blockers where you can block out all social media or notifications on your phone or desktop for a period of time so you can truly avoid distractions and have a great focus time, baby. A great focus time. Tip seven, batch your tasks. So I love batching my tasks because I don't want to engage different parts of my brain all at the same time and just make myself super tired. For example, if I wanted brainstorm video ideas, I make sure I do that all in one go for several videos. That way I know my mind is in the creativity mood and not in like the critical analytical mood. That's what I love about it. Like batch all your emails in the morning and reply to them all so you don't have to deal with them for the rest of the day. Tip eight, break up your day. As soon as you feel yourself start to doze off or like wander off or go on social media, get up. Don't do it within the area that you're studying and go walk a dog. Don't want to associate your workspace with unproductivity. Or you'll do it again and then you'll start wandering off in your head and then you're gone. One of my favorite things to do is using tasks as timers. For example, I'll chuck on my dishwasher and I'll make sure I'll work the 2 hours it takes my dishwasher to get going. And once it's done is when I stop. I can do that with laundry too, in which if I want to study just for 1 hour, chuck on my laundry and then I pull it out at the end and that's my timer. So you end up being super productive while also doing other tasks as well, if you want to do it that way. Tip 9, FaceTime your friends. FaceTime your friends who also work from home, or you can also invite them over and just do like a study sesh or a work sesh and make sure that you guys actually concentrate. I have friends that I do this with and sometimes it doesn't work all the time, but most of the time if you guys have like fixed tasks and you tell each other about it and keep each other accountable, then it can work. It can work. Tip 10, snacks. I love snacks. I love them so much. Use snacks or treats as positive reinforcement after you complete a task or while you're going through tasks. Obviously, if you're trying to be healthy and you don't want to involve snacks into this, you can be like, I get to read one chapter of this book that I love if I do this. We're like reward-based system animals. This is just who we are. We have to trick ourselves. Anyways, thank you so much for watching and I hope these 10 tips helped you. If you enjoy productivity videos and just like self-development and just me in general and my doggo because she comes in videos, okay? Then please subscribe to this channel. I'd really appreciate it. Follow me on Instagram for random things right here. And I'll see you guys next time. Bye! Mwah!